Hello students, I hope you all fine. Now start with the questions on capital reduction or internal reconstruction. Let's have a question on this. We have been given balance sheet of Chetna Limited, and below the balance sheet, if you see, there is a one word. If you see below the balance sheet, it is given that due to adverse position of a company, court has approved the scheme of capital reduction as per the following conditions. Means company has gone for the capital reduction scheme. Now we have a number of transactions, and last it's given that we have to pass the journal entry. Give it for every transaction of a capital reduction. So our main answer is a basically it's a journal entry which we need to give it. So we have four transaction, and for this four transaction we have to pass the journal entry. Now before we go for the journal entry, we have to first always in the balance sheet we find out that is there any reserve on the liability side. So if you see, there is a general reserve. Now why we have find it out general reserve? Because this we utilize for creating the artificial profit, and some of the asset whether mentioned in question or not, we have to eliminate. What are the things that we have to always eliminate? That is one, it's always being the P&L debit balance, that's accumulated loss we have to remove, and we have to remove preliminary expenses. Means we have to remove fictitious asset. Balance sheet ma apne kidu hai ke no kidu hai apne ane to eliminate kari j nakhvano. And one more thing, if at all company gone for internal reconstruction, basically we don't require the goodwill. So goodwill pon atle atli item to apne question ma mention na kariyo to pan apne remove karna chu, write down karna chu. Now if you go for the transactions one by one, we give the effect to these transactions. Now first transaction is equity shares are reduced by 8 per share. Reduced by 8 per share. What is the amount of equity share given in the balance sheet? It's 10 rupee. Now 10 rupee share has been reduced by 8. So there is a reduction of 8 rupees per equity shares. 8 rupees is reduced. Now reduction may be change in face value, may be change in paid up value, but it's nothing given in the question. So we assume that company has reduced its paid up value. So whenever there is a change in paid up value, there is a only reduction in share capital. So 8 rupees reduced. How many shares are there? 5 lakh divided by 10. It's 50,000 shares. So share capital is reduced. Entry would be first reduction in reduction in equity shares. 8 rupees we reduce, so 8 rupees when we reduce, it's 50,000 into 8, so it's 4 lakh rupees. So entry would be now share capital is reduced. Share capital is always having credit balance. If you want to reduce, you have to debit. So entry would be equity share capital account debit to capital reduction ₹50,000 × 8. So it's 4 lakh rupees. What is the effect of this transaction? After this effect, now in the balance sheet share would be now it's only 2 rupees. Then second adjustment is preference share are reduced by 5 rupees. 10 rupees share is reduced by 5 rupees. How many shares are there? 25,000. So second transaction is reduction in preference share. Again, preference share capital is having credit balance. When we reduce, it's debit. So entry would be preference share capital account. How many shares are there? 2,50,000. 10 each, 25,000. And 5 rupee is reduced, preference reduced by 5. So 25,000 into 5. So it's 1,25,000. And without payment, share value has reduced, so it's benefit to the company. So this benefit is to be credited to capital reduction account. Third transaction, all fictitious assets are to be written off. Fictitious, what is a fictitious asset? Fictitious asset is, fictitious asset is preliminary expenses and P&L, and balance of general reserve should be transferred to capital reduction account. Now the fictitious asset is given, but as I told you, always if we, even if it is nothing, even it's not given, we should write down the all those asset which is fictitious, as well as those assets which are intangible. So here we have a goodwill, also we have a pattern. This is also to be written down. So entry would be third assets written down. Entry would be goodwill account debit, patent account debit, preliminary expenses account debit, and P&L account debit. Goodwill, amount of the goodwill is 75,000. Amount of patent would be 25,000. Preliminary expenses 25,000. And P&L 225. So, and this all the assets. It's to be written off. So it is written off against this is to be written off against capital reduction. In fact, capital reduction account debit to goodwill amount is 75,000. To patent account, it's 25 to preliminary expenses, now that is 25 to P&L to 25. See, these are all the assets having debit balance. When we cancel, it has to be credited and it is to be charged against capital reduction account. The total would be 2 plus 3, 3 lakh 50,000. Then fourth adjustment is, if you see, general reserve account should be, general reserve account should be transferred to capital reduction. General reserve is 25,000. Reserve is credit balance. When we utilize credit balance, it has to be debited. So entry would be, now use of general reserve. So entry would be general reserve account debit to capital reduction. Amount of general reserve is 25,000. Thereafter, reduce the asset as under. Reduce. So first of all, plant. What is the value of plant? 1,50,000. Reduce to 90. So there is a loss of plant. There is a loss of 60,000. Then debtors. 40,000 debtors, now 15. So there is a loss of 25,000. Then stock, 35, stock is 10,000, so there is a loss of stock, there is a loss of 25,000. Then furniture, it's 45 become 25, so there is a reduction of 20,000. And vehicle, 90,000 rupee vehicle, now valued at 55, so there is a loss of 35,000. So there is a loss in all the assets. Assets is having debit balance. If the value decrease, we have to credit, and a loss can charge karsu, where we charge capital reduction. So reduction in assets. So reduction in assets, entry would be entry would be capital reduction account debit to first of all to plant, that is we have written 60,000, vehicle, that is 35,000, furniture, that is 20,000. To stock, 25,000. To debtors, 25,000. So the total of all would be 60,000 plus 35,000. 60,000 plus 35,000 plus 20 plus 50. It would be 165. Now all the transactions are taken care. So now whatever, if we have the balance in the capital reduction account, we need to transfer to capital reserve. So if you see in the first entry, we have credited 4 lakh rupees to capital reduction. Second entry, we have credited 125. Then we have debited 3,50,000. Then we have credited 25,000 and we have debited 1,65,000. So there is a 35,000 rupee balance which we need to transfer to capital reserve. So last entry would be transfer to capital reserve. Capital reduction account debit 35,000 to capital reserve 35,000. Capital reserve is having credit balance to transfer, we have to debit and we have to credit it to capital reserve. This is the entry for capital reduction. This is how you have to approach the question. Thank you very much.